Let me start with an experiment, and you all can join me if you wish. Put your thumb out and say, neutrinos. See anything? Feel any different? To the naked eye, nothing would be the correct answer. But invisible to our eyes, a billion tiny fundamental particles pass right through your thumbnail every second. And of course, it's not just the thumb. At night, when the sun is on the other side of the Earth, and these particles are coming mostly from the sun, they pass right through the Earth, right through your bed and through your body out into the space. It is this nature of neutrinos that gives them their pet name, the ghost particles. The curious thing about these neutrinos is that they come in three flavors: muon neutrino, electron neutrino, and tau neutrino. But flavors reminds all of us of ice cream, so I'm going to call them strawberry, chocolate, and mint. Now, the weird thing is that these flavors of neutrinos, they change from one kind to the other. Imagine your strawberry ice cream changing to chocolate or mint. This is known as neutrino oscillation. When it was discovered, it defied all known laws of physics. In fact, the 2015 Nobel Prize in Physics was awarded to the experimental detection of neutrino oscillation. The experiment that I work on is based in Japan. On the east coast of Japan, we produce a beam of muon neutrinos, and then we just let them pass through the Earth for 200 miles before we detect them on the west coast of Japan. On the west coast, we see how many of these muon neutrinos changed to electron neutrinos, or from chocolate to mint. Now let's say we have a detector on the west coast that looks at the color of the ice cream to detect what flavor it is. If it's brown, it's chocolate. If it's green, then it's mint. Easy. But the problem happens when we have these other particles called pi zero particles that kind of look like pistachio ice cream. And now our detector gets confused: green, mint, or pistachio. So we built this another detector which specializes in detecting the pistachio ice cream or the pi zero particle. It can, for instance, look at the texture of the ice cream. If it hits a hard nut, then we know it's pistachio and that not mint. I calculate how many pistachio ice cream would be produced so that we can subtract this number from the mint ice cream number to get a more precise calculation of this neutrino oscillation from chocolate to mint or from muon neutrino to electron neutrino. These accurate and precise calculations will help us better understand these elusive, mysterious ghost particles, which are one of the fundamental particles that form you, me, and the entire universe. Thank you. Let me start with an experiment, and all of you can join me if you wish. Put your thumb out and say, neutrinos. Did you see anything? Feel any different? I see some head shakes. To the naked eye, nothing is the correct answer. But invisible to our eyes, tens of billions of tiny fundamental particles called neutrinos pass right through your thumbnail. And of course, it's not just the thumb. At night, when the sun is on the other side of the Earth, and most of these neutrinos coming from the sun, go right through the Earth, right through your bed, through your body, and out into the space. It is this behavior of these particles which gives them their pet name, the ghost particles. Now, neutrinos come in three flavors: the muon neutrino, the electron neutrino, and the tau neutrino. But since flavors makes us think of ice cream, I'm going to call it strawberry, chocolate, and mint. Now, these three flavors of neutrinos, they change from one kind to the other. Imagine your strawberry ice cream changing to chocolate or mint. This is known as neutrino oscillation. When it was discovered, it defied all known laws of physics. In fact, the 2015 Nobel Prize in Physics was awarded to the experimental detection of neutrino oscillation. The experiment that I work on is located in Japan. On the east coast of Japan, we produce a beam of muon neutrinos. We then just point them in the Earth and let them travel for 200 miles before we detect them on the west coast of Japan. On the west coast, we see how many of these muon neutrinos change to electron neutrinos, or from chocolate to mint. So imagine we have a detector that looks at the color of the ice cream. If it's brown, then it's chocolate. If it's green, then it's mint. Easy. But the problem occurs when there are these other particles that get produced called pi zero particles, which are like pistachio ice cream. Now our detector is confused. Green, is it mint or pistachio? So I work on this other smaller detector that we built in the path, which looks, let's say, at the texture of the ice cream. Every time it hits a hard nut, it knows it's pistachio and not mint. So I calculate how many of these pistachio ice cream would be produced so that we can subtract that number from the number of mint ice creams to get a more accurate measurement of this chocolate to mint oscillation or from muon to electron neutrino oscillation. Knowing these measurements more precisely will help us understand these elusive, mysterious ghost particles and give us a better grip on these fundamental particles from which you and I and this universe is made up of. Thank you.
Our second winner for People's Choice Award category is Zoya Vallari, Department of Physics.
What flavor of ice cream would you like? The chocolate, the strawberry, or never mind.
Chocolate.
Me too. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations, Zoya. Yes.
And our first place award goes to, and no one knows this except for my student assistant, capturing ghost particles and telling apart real from fake, Zoya Vallari, Department of Physics. And last but not least, Zoya.